Good evening. My name is Sam Fishman.
Thank you.
And I am privileged to serve as the Managing Director of Sinai Schools. In tonight's feature film, you are about to meet another Sinai student, Jacob Adler. Jacob is about the same age as Menashe, and while Jacob has faced very different challenges, both Menashe and Jacob are Sinai success stories. Jacob's accomplishments are towering, and what Jacob has taught the world, as you will see in tonight's film, is so important. Jacob's footprints is not just intended to make you fall in love with Jacob, though you will. And it is not intended just to tug at your heart, though you may find parts of it very moving. It is a film with several important messages. Among those messages is this: inclusion matters. As you watch the film, pay attention to the interactions between the Kushner students and the Sinai students, and between the TABC students and the Sinai students. That goes on every day at every one of our partner schools. Look at what our students are gaining, and look at what our partner school students are gaining by having Sinai students in their midst. I have a request for each of you in this room on behalf of the person who is sitting next to you. This is a delicate, emotional film. We would be grateful if you would please turn off your phone so the glare or sound of your phone does not spoil the film for your neighbor. Thank you. Tonight's film, Jacob's Footprints, and all of tonight's videos will be up on our website and Facebook page as soon as this dinner ends. Sinai's recent films have been viewed online hundreds of thousands of times, and the resulting growth of our schools and in our fundraising has been extraordinary. So if you are moved by the film you are about to see, please share it with everyone. I want to thank Abigail Heppner-Gross, our director of communications, who partnered with me to create tonight's entire program, including Jacob's Footprints. Abigail and I look forward to hearing your feedback. Debbie and Hillel, and of course Jacob, thank you for letting us tell your story.
Jacob was born 32 weeks, so he was born early, premature.
I kept saying, something's wrong, and he kept saying, he'll be fine, he'll catch up, but then he didn't.
So Jacob had some medical challenges early on. He didn't reach milestones when he was supposed to, like walking and crawling and things like that.
And then we went to a neurologist who examined him and then handed us a bill. And on the bill, it said CP, quadriplegia, and that's how we found out what was wrong with him.
He was diagnosed with cerebral palsy at about 5-6 months of age.
I remember very clearly one day speaking to the physiatrist who said, you know, you are clearly understanding, and a lot of parents don't understand this, that walking is not going to be the way he gets around. And I remember sitting there and thinking, oh, I didn't know that I understood that. It was a little bit of a wake-up call. Here was the doctor saying you could work with him 24 hours a day. It's not going to change.
I'd be broken because my body broke.
Well, having a child with special needs is stressful for sure. It certainly has stressed us in a lot of ways.
It's heartbreaking. Even after 18 years,
there are still mornings that I wake up. Sorry. And for a second, I forget. And it's really hard.
You have to really be strong. I mean, we have to be strong for each other, and you have to just try and keep a positive outlook on anything. That's really the main thing we have to do, is always try and say to each other, be positive. Let's try and make him feel like he's not different, make him feel like he's like everybody else as best as we can. And he'll feed off of that. Jacob's physical issues impact his learning abilities.
Okay, let me check your homework.
Because of his control of muscles, so even his eyes as he's reading, to not be able to follow along or follow the words on the line is something that he's challenged with. So, yeah, Jacob has physical needs, and you can't just simply just put him in a school that's physically accessible. You have to take into account his accessible needs, but also how he can learn in a unique way.
11 and
10. Here at Sinai Schools, we look at whole children. We look at what are their abilities and what do they need to grow. Jacob is a child who needed to learn in his way, on his level, in a small group.
9 plus 1 is always?
Sinai School customized the program around his needs, both physically and socially, and of course educationally.
We have a class of 6 or 7 students, and there are 3 adults in the classroom. We have aides for some of our students. We have physical therapists and occupational therapists and speech therapists and art therapists and music therapists.
They're saying, let's take this child, let's recognize that they learn differently, let's find the most appropriate way to educate them, the best way to include them in the mainstream school setting, and how they can be a part of the community.
So frequently, parents of children with special needs hear, no, no, we can't help you, no, we can't accept your child. At Sinai, we try so hard to figure out the possibilities and to be able to say, yes, yes, we can help. Yes, we can make this work.
For me, it's somebody that is recognizing that Jacob is worth educating. That's not a small thing.
Jacob's bar mitzvah was planned for a while. We wanted him to have the same opportunity like his brothers to read from the Torah and shul.
About 2 years prior to his bar mitzvah, we started talking about exactly what we were going to do for Jacob at his bar mitzvah.
We never said to Jacob, no, you can't do it, just because his voice wasn't the same as everyone else's. And again, Sinai recognized that and knew that he could do it. And Jake Weinstein was amazing. He took Jacob and worked with him tirelessly for days and weeks and months just to read a few psukim of the Torah.
This is a child who's happy and makes everybody around him happy. So we wanted to make his bar mitzvah something very special.
I think what Sinai did was allowed us to push the envelope to see how much he can do. Because it's never just enough to just say, let's just try to do the minimum. Let's try and maximize his abilities.
The synagogue holds about 400 people. And I must say, when he was finally called up for his part to read, 400 people stood up and were totally silent for the few minutes that he was up there.
Jacob got up there on a ramp in front of the whole shul, and the place, you couldn't hear a peep. The place was absolutely silent, standing in almost in reverence and in awe of Jacob.
You cannot imagine the tear-jerking moment when Jakey held the Torah, when they took it out of the ark, and he said Shema Yisrael, leading the entire congregation.
I call these bar mitzvahs Kleenex days. Everybody was crying.
It was just incredible. And then when he was called up to the Torah for his aliyah, and he read the maftir, it was something that no one will ever forget, and it was one of the most meaningful moments in the history of Rinat. I've been the rabbi for 35 years, and it's one of the highlights of my career.
Thank everybody for coming.
It was such a fantastic moment. They had worked so hard to get to that moment.
It's a great day. Great day.
It was amazing.
And Sinai helped them get there.
When a student comes to Sinai Shalem at CABC, our first step is to project where we believe he will be years down the road as he prepares for his adulthood. And then we backtrack and plan an educational program, a vocational program, social opportunities to best prepare him for that future.
What's so great about the way Sinai educates Jacob is that they cater his education to his specific needs. In a typical class, you might learn math, how to add and subtract. For Jacob, it's how do I go to the store and buy something, and how do I get change if I paid too much? That's something that he's going to need in real life.
I've been learning bugging and counting the money. It's very important because you don't run out of money.
What's unique about our high school program is the vocational realm. Preparing a student in high school while he's still in a learning mode to be an employee, learning job skills, learning how to be on time and how to be professional.
I work at EJ. My job is to fold big boxes.
In addition, there are goals within the life skills realm, how to prepare simple meals, how to use a microwave.
Socially, he just had an amazing time.
The inclusion model at Sinai at TABC is really fundamental to the experience that our students have each day.
He has a lot of friends at TABC. Everybody knows him there. Everybody's so friendly.
I'm the same as everyone else. And even though I'm a little difficult, I could be the same way as Diane.
His friends were coming and picking him up to hang out on Friday night and on Shabbos afternoon and even Sundays.
Now you look at Jacob at 18 years old, and everything's about inclusion and freedom and independence. This is what this child needs, and it's defined him.
Senior, like every other senior, and he was thrilled to get his cap and gown, and he was ready to go to lead the charge at graduation.
You know, when a kid goes up for an award, the cameras are always focused on the kid. I was looking out at the crowd at the time, just hearing everybody cheering, Jacob, Jacob, and watching his friends, you know, cheering for him, and the whole crowd really just, you know, making him feel like he's number one was just an emotional time. And Jacob was on top of the world that night. He had the balloons around him, he had the women around him, he had the flowers around him. He was on top of the world.
To watch his peers cheer him on, it felt like the special night that it was supposed to be for Jacob and for us. It was really nice.
Maybe a little bit.
A little faster. It's incredibly important to recognize the human capacity that somebody else has, despite the fact that they are handicapped with a variety of challenges.
Jacob is a model of someone who lives a life within the realm of impossible and who is striving to redefine his story as a reality.
He thinks he could do anything. We have a lot to learn from that. When I was training for my first marathon, I was thinking about Jacob and, you know, somewhere in mile 23 and you think, I can't do this. And I think about the marathons that he faces every single day.
Okay, let's do it again.
He's a role model for all of us.
Good.
To realize how much potential we have if we could turn all the no's into yeses, if we can dream a little bit larger, a little bit bigger, and realize that our dreams could be reality.
That's it.
People see Jacob as a guy in a wheelchair. He can't walk, and he speaks not as fluently as others, but really, on the inside, he's no different than anyone else. Having Jacob in my life was one of the best things that ever happened to me. It allowed me to see no difference between anybody.
When I was in high school, we had to write an essay about our role models. So all my friends were thinking, oh, which athlete should I write about? Which celebrity should I write about? Which politician should I write about? And for me, it was a no-brainer. Jacob was my role model. Jacob is my role model.
It's eye-opening to see what he's taught the world. Jacob, a child in a wheelchair, has left such a profound footprint on our community and on our school.
Song for you, my child, as I watch you grow and hear your laughter. It wasn't long ago when I couldn't find a way to help you. I wanted all for you. Inside my arms, child inside my open
arms. Thank you, Mom and Dad. Thank you, Kai.
A song for you, my child, filled with hope and joy, 'cause they embrace you. What a change in you, in the open arms, the arms of Sinai. I want it all for you. I want all of your dreams to come true. I want it all for you.
Jacob, we have an exciting one last surprise for you. Last night, I know you saw Carmelo Anthony ice the game against the 76ers. This evening, we have a personalized gift from himself, Carmelo Anthony, a New York Knicks jersey and a signed hat by Carmelo Anthony, your biggest fan.
Want it all for you. I want all of your dreams to come true. I want it all for you. There is nothing that I wouldn't do. In the arms of Sinai. A song for you, my child, filled with hope and joy, 'cause they embrace you. What a change in you. In the open arms, the arms of Sinai. I want it.